from all across the world. The brave and the bonkers take on the 4-stage obstacle course designed to test competitors' speed, balance, dexterity, and ultimate skill. One man proved it could be done. Could another? It's time again for Ninja Warrior of Halo! Welcome back to Ninja Warrior of Halo. Last time, the first 20 out of 40 challengers took on Stage 1, many of them newcomers. And whilst most fell early, two men did manage to survive to reach the finish line. Close friends and members of the group called the Quadruple Rangers, Irish 1200, and X-Dom de Bomb X. Today is the turn of the next 12 contestants, which include a number of returning contestants and two newcomers who could be in with a chance. Pro Marksman iSpiteful and Spartan Warrior veteran spacevortex. How will they do? Let's find out. First up on the course is Black Ghost. How's he going to do on the course? 85 seconds for 6 obstacles. First obstacle is the hurdle jump. And he's moving across it quite nicely over all of the hurdles, and now he's onto the rolling ball. Got to roll the ball down the track, but first he's got to get it onto the track, which he seems to be having trouble at doing at the moment. Come on, Black Ghost. He's rolled it back. He's not really moving it. Oh no, he shot it! That was a mistake! He's knocked the ball completely off the track! Oh my goodness. Still, he's out. Next up is Devil Master 13. Another newcomer. How's he gonna do? 85 seconds for 6 obstacles. He's over the first hurdle, but he slipped up on the second hurdle. Next up is Soul Reaper 1025. Soul Reaper 1025 competed on the original Halo Reach tournament, and after a 2-tournament gap, returned in the last tournament. But since then, he's established himself as a member of Extreme UK Gaming. So the question is, can he improve on his record today? So, Soul Reaper, as I say, current member of Extreme UK Gaming, this channel, so you can expect videos out from him, hopefully in the not too distant future. He's looking at trying to do some computer games, Let's Plays on computer games. Now he's onto the rolling ball, which was his nemesis in the last tournament. Oh, but not this time, he's over it. Big puff of smoke when he landed. Now for the rising pillars, 3 pillars, get higher, and he's over them all. Now for the jump hang. He goes for it, hits the trampoline, but doesn't find anywhere to land. Next up is Spartan 781. He's another returning contestant who runs his own Ninja Warrior based obstacle course, so he should be familiar with these obstacles. Well, he's done the course before and he's overcome the hurdle jump, which is where he fell last time at. Now for the rolling ball. Ties it up. Oh, he slipped. Oh, and that slip has cost him. He's fallen. Next up is Dusterbuster 2K1. Another returning contestant. He's making his 4th appearance on the course. He's the last of the contestants or members of the group called the Quadruple Rangers. The other 3 have already done their runs. 2 of them have already advanced. Irish 1200 next on the Bomb X. So, can they make it a hat-trick of Rangers through to Stage 2 with just this success? He's having a little bit of trouble on the rolling ball. Looks like he's going to try and push it onto the track. Ooh, almost slipped off there, but he's recovered and he's over. That was a little bit costly in time though. Rising pillars shouldn't be a trouble for him, although he has fallen on them once before. Now for the jump hang, which is where he fell in the last tournament. He runs, he jumps, he's short, oh he's touched the water, he's out! And he's fallen in the water anyway. Replay shows you cannot touch the water under any circumstances, otherwise it's instant disqualification. Next up is Smoky Massacre, another returning contestant and another person who runs his own obstacle course. So again, having run his own obstacle course, he should be familiar with these kinds of obstacles, or some of them at least, because he does his own obstacle course, obviously. Rolling ball is where he fell in the last tournament. He's got a good rhythm this time round, and he is over it. Now for the rising pillars. It's his second appearance on the course. And now for the jump hang, he's never tried it before, so this will be quite an experience. Will it be a good experience though? Yes it will, he's on! And he's going to sneak his way underneath, but he's got to make sure not to touch the water like Duster did. He's snuck through and now he's got to get through the maze as well though, and he's stuck. This is costing him a few valuable seconds. He's got about 30 seconds to go as he approaches the warped wall. So he wanted to get up this in one. Ooh, 20 seconds to go. This could be close. He's over now and he's onto the final steps. 10 seconds, the buzzer is sounding. Come on, Smoky Massacre, it's going to be close, it is going to be close. But he's crossed the line with 2.1 seconds to spare. Following Smoky's success, three more men took on the course. But sadly for Mike GNL, and for his friend Marco Style NL, they couldn't repeat his performance. The third man to go was a returning veteran called a Medpack, and he came back with a vengeance. After failing on stage 1 in his last two appearances, he was able to put on a near-perfect performance this time round, ultimately finishing the course with 9.3 seconds to spare. Now let's have a look at today's Spartan Wipeout. The honour goes to our first contestant, Black Ghost, who achieved a first ever on Ninja Warrior of Halo, knocking the rolling ball off the track during an official run. Still, if you gotta go, better to go in style. Now it's the turn of iSpiteful, a newcomer who could be in with a chance here. He's a established shooter, especially on Halo Reach, and he's also a pretty good jumper. Can't speak today, guys. Anyway, and he's showing his skills so far. He's very quick at the moment. He's already onto the rolling ball. Nicely onto the track and a nice rhythm. And he's over. Now for the rising pillars. Still moving fast. Oh, a bit too fast. No, it's cost him. He's fallen. Next up is Sniper761, another returning contestant who does a spin on the first jump. Sniper is a memorable character, he's a very confident young man, and always likes to move at a quick pace. What the heck was that? Gee, we're going to have a look at that again at the end. Now he's onto the rising pillars where he fell last time out. How did he just do that? Jump hang. Still moving fast and he's on and he's climbing up. Yes, as I say, he's a man who likes to move very quick, very skillful, as we've already seen on the rolling ball. Could he go all the way here? Warped wall. Doesn't get it on his first try, but he does on his second try and he's onto the final steps. He's landed halfway up and he's still got bags of time in hand. He is going to make this, and with a very nice time as well. In fact, it is 21.6 seconds to spare, fastest time by a mile so far. Now, let's have a quick replay back at the rolling ball. He pushes the ball onto the track, then stops it by shooting it on the bottom. Completely drops its speed and then he can get onto it easily. Well, last up is Space Vortex, another newcomer, and he's a Spartan Warrior veteran, established competitor on that show. He managed to get to stage 2 a number of times, I believe, on that course, which established him as one of the top jumpers back in the old days. From what I know, he's taken a bit of a back seat more recently, hasn't really competed on many obstacle courses to my knowledge, but he's here today. So, will he be able to put on a good show for us? Could he get to stage 2 on his debut? Be good if he could. That would really show off his skills and ability if he could on his very first try. Now he's onto the rising pillars. Over them nicely, just about. And now onto the jump hang. He's not the fastest, he lost a little bit of time on the rolling ball. He's coming up to about just under 40 seconds now, so he might have to hurry. He's climbing nicely though. Oh no, no, he hasn't, he slipped off, oh! Wow, that was unexpected, and with that we've completed today's episode. 5 men are now through to stage 2, including the 3 that completed it today. Join us next time for the final 8 challenges, which include some of the best jumpers there are on this course. Until then, I've been Hunter Unit 751. Remember to like, comment on what you liked on the video, and subscribe. Until then, ta-ta!